So what is up, guys? Today we're going to go over how to get diamond launchers. So first up is the SMAW. Now we're going to go over the challenges one by one here. And after you have destroyed 100 aircraft with the SMAW, we're going to carbon fiber. Get 10 impact kills with the SMAW. That's basically running up to someone and knocking him with that SMAW. And for that, you want to be a little bit stealthy, so I recommend Ghost. Fast hands, you can swap over to it very quickly. And the scavenger pack, you can actually replenish your rockets if you get gun kills. Extreme conditioning will just help you get into position. And the concussions, you know, if you see someone off in the distance, a concussion is a great way to pretty much immobilize them. So it really isn't that hard, you know, once you're used to the fact of being stealthy and swapping over to the SMAW really quick. Probably one of the easier challenges. So next up is Cherry Blossom. Destroy 5 aircraft in a single game. For that, I recommend Ground War. There's just so many UAVs and counters up and all that stuff. So Ground War is a good way to knock out that challenge. Art of War. Get 1 kill from a car using SMAW. That was pretty easy. I did that on Nuketown. You know, just run upstairs, wait till someone got next to the car and blew it up. If you don't have Nuketown, then you're not going to have a good time. I don't know how to put it to you. If you don't have Nuketown, it's just going to be basically luck. So that's that challenge. Ronin. Get 5 double kill medals using the SMAW. Actually, very easy. For this, I recommend Fast Hands. All you got to do is shoot someone with your gun, swap over to the SMAW really quick. Hopefully, there's someone nearby. Boom, blow them up. That counts as a double kill. You don't need to kill 2 people with 1 rocket, okay? Next up is Skull. Destroy 1 Dragonfire with the SMAW. This isn't hard. This is just time consuming and requires a luck, because nowadays people really don't use that Dragonfire. So if you really, really want to make sure you get that kill, then you would probably want to have a cold-blooded perk enabled. But otherwise, this is just a little bit of luck, and you know, it's going to be time consuming only because people don't tend to use those. All right, so next up is the FHJ, and after you have destroyed 100 aircraft with the FHJ, we go on to carbon fiber. Destroyed 10 aircraft quickly as it entered the airspace. Pretty straightforward. Cherry Blossom, destroyed 5 aircraft in a single game. Simple enough. Ground War will probably be your best bet because there's, again, a lot of UAV. Art of War, destroyed 2 aircraft back to back at one time. Again, Ground War is your best bet. Ronin, destroyed 10 player controlled score streaks. Now for this, you probably want to have the cold blooded perk just to keep that red diamond off of you if you really want to, you know, make your job a little bit easier. It's not necessary, but you know, when someone's got that red diamond up, it's going to make it hard for you. Blind Eye can help just in case, you know, there's a random hunter killer laying around and you're going to be mad when you've got your lock on into a Dragonfire or something, and then boom, you get hit by hunter killer or, you know, chopper knocks you down or something. All right, next up is Skulls. Destroy 1 AGR with the FHJ. This is going to be tough because not very many people use the AGR. I don't know why. It's a great kill streak. And for this, you're probably going to want to shock it with the EMP first, because it's going to be real tough locking onto it twice. So definitely, you know, put some damage into it and then use the FHJ. All right, next up, my favorite, the RPG. So after you've got 100 kills with RPG, move on to get 10 impact kills with the RPG. Pretty much like the SMAW, you're going to want to have concussions. Just to slow down people when you see them. Extreme conditioning, you can run up to them. And the scavenger isn't necessary, but I do recommend fast hands. You could swap over really quick and just blow them up. And blind eye, I personally use that just because random hunter killers, God, it's just so upsetting when you're right about to blow up somebody and then boom, hunter killer gets you, or, you know, chopper or something. Next up, Cherry Blossom. Destroy 1 aircraft using the RPG. Again, for that, I would highly recommend Blind Eye. And it's a little bit of luck being able to hit a stealth chopper. Alright, so next up is Art of War. Get 1 kill from a car using the RPG. Just like the SMAW, I recommend Nuketown playlist or Chaos. if you don't have Nuketown and you're in for a bad time, don't know what else to tell you, it's gonna take a little bit of luck. Ronin, get 5 double kill medals using the RPG, just like the Smaw, you know, use our little trick. I highly recommend Fast Hands, get 2 kills with your weapon, swap over to the RPG, hopefully there's someone around, boom, that counts as the double or triple kill, because when you move over to Skulls, you need 1 triple kill, and you know, just gotta get 2 gun kills, swap over, boom, and that's it. And that pretty much wraps it up, guys. If this helped you out, go ahead and please leave a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it, and I'll see you next time. I'm going to show you how I got Diamond or Bedazzled Snipers. Now, this is the technique that worked for me. You could use this as a guide. So I'm going to go through all the snipers and what I did for each one of them. So first up is the SVUAS. So for this, all these...